I'm Annie, and I just got back from studying at the University of Sydney this past semester. I want to share some of my absolute favorite things about studying abroad, and specifically studying abroad in Sydney. First and foremost, I have to give a shout out to their food. They just have such a good thing going on over there. Avocado toast, Spice Alley, brunch. I took classes with all the many other students at UCID. So there's about 50,000 undergraduate students there, so I was just one of the many. I took 3 classes for my degree. So I'm studying behavioral neuroscience with a minor in computer science. And then for the last spot, I took glass blowing, which was so cool. Something I never thought I would do before. But I got a bike to the other campus, which is the Arts College campus. Also, the Great Hall, the main building on campus, is consistently BuzzFeed accredited as one of the most Hogwarts-esque buildings in the world. So my building that I lived in was pretty much all American and or other international students studying abroad, which at first I was like, oh, come on, I came here to meet Australians. But that ended up being such a cool opportunity. I now feel like I know people from all over the world. I was really lucky with my roommates. So I lived in a 6-person flat, all random people, and they turned out to be some of my absolute best friends in the world. The kids who go to UCID, most of them live like about an hour outside of the city and they just commute in. So it's kind of hard to meet them at night because they don't really hang out in Sydney at night. But in general, the Aussies that I did meet were so fun and happy. They're really, really big on flying there. Like our orientation, I think a good 20 minutes of it was just this like video about all the slang in Australian that we'd have to pick up on. And like, it's pretty intuitive. Like for example, they'll say like arvo instead of afternoon. And that often gets confused with avo for avocado, because they say it the same way. It's like, this avo, what? Another great aspect of Sydney particularly is the art and culture scene. During pretty much the entire month from late May to late June, Sydney had this festival called Vivid, and it was a festival of light, color, and sound. So I'm a neuroscience person and I'm really interested in synesthesia, which is a condition where you experience multiple senses at once. So this was like my inner nerdy heaven. The iconic Sydney Opera House. I actually took a guided tour of the Opera House where we learned about some of its history, which is really cool. The winning design was by this Danish architect, Jørn Utzon, who unfortunately did not live to see his dream come to reality. When you study abroad, this is true of pretty much anywhere you go. You can travel so much of that area. I traveled early with my mom and aunt to New Zealand and some places around Australia. And then while I was in Sydney, I also got to travel around Australia. Like, we went to Melbourne. Don't say Melbourne, it's so cringe. The Great Barrier Reef. The Outback. I went on a solo trip to the Outback for a week. That was awesome. And during the mid-semester break, I went to Bali in Indonesia. There's a ton of coastal walks. There's Bondi to Coogee Beach. Shark Beach, which is pretty ironic because it gets the name from the fact that it has a massive net around the swimming area that blocks all sharks. They also have some national parks pretty close to Sydney. So the Royal National Park, you can take a 45-minute train right there. So on a more serious note, I think jetting off on your own 10,000 miles away and kind of starting life over again in such a new place, I really feel like I learned a lot about myself and grew a lot more self-sufficient and self-confident during this time. For those of you watching this who are thinking about studying abroad or, you know, on the horizons of possibility, I will personally email you the application because I think this was the best decision I could have made in my life. So anyway, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this little tour of Australia. It made me really nostalgic, I miss it already. And I wish you the best of luck with your future jet-setting abroad adventures.